Hey guys, it's August 1st today. Happy August. I always manage to start these vlogs looking not great. Like, I just did my workout and had a shower and now I'm all like shiny and clean-faced, bare-faced. Oh well. I'm not sure if I'm gonna stitch today, but I'm just sitting at my desk. I'm gonna work on my coursework for a little while and I thought I would show you this like organizational board that I made. So this is my little whiteboard that I bought at Walmart, and I bought it because I wanted to, gosh, I'm sitting down and this is less easy than I thought. Let me stand up. I got it because I wanted to make sure to set goals for myself for this course. I didn't think I would, I'm not really the type to like fall behind on things, but you know, I'm a type A type, so this is what I did. So down here, these are my two modules that I'm gonna work on this week. This board unofficially is like a Monday to Sunday board. I write on it on Monday, today's Monday, for the week. So these are the two modules that I'm hoping to work on, keyboarding techniques and then grammar and style. These are supposed to be, like, keyboarding techniques I think is supposed to take like 5 days. So I don't know. I don't know if it will. I don't know. Then I have my four, these are just boxes for me to check. So I have my four little workout boxes, so I can check one of those off today. I try to go Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then one weekend day. I have my, when my bills are due up there. And then up on the top, I have just like my chores that I want to get done this week. So film is number one. See, I'm trying you guys. I want to claim some prescriptions. I got to clean my apartment and do some laundry. I might add some more to that actually. And then at the very top, I have no more 3 a.m.s. That's to remind me while I'm sitting at this desk doing this coursework, the reason I'm doing this coursework, no more 3 a.m.s. I do not want to get up at 3 a.m. anymore. And then at the bottom, I just have some little notes for myself. I have stay focused, ease up. That's the most important one. I am very hard on myself. I'm a person that is like terribly hard on myself. So ease up is for that. And then I have do your best. So that is my little whiteboard. Hey guys, it's August 5th today. I had a really good day today. I had a short day at work, so I only worked 7 hours instead of 7.5, which doesn't seem like it would be a big difference, but it means that I get off at 11 instead of 11:30. And something about being done work at 11 in the morning is just wonderful. Like, you can go have lunch and it's still really early. I don't know, it's a mental thing. So that, and then after work I walked around the exhibition with my mom. I don't know if exhibition is like a term that's used everywhere, so it's just like our fair, you know, with like rides and food. We don't go on any rides anymore. They're so expensive. So we just pay the egregious amount to get in to the exhibition, and then we just wander around and look at the shopping and eat food. So here's a list of things that I ate at exhibition this afternoon. First I had tacos, because I always get tacos from the taco truck there. And then I had, my mom and I split the hugest like basket of seasoned fries, which were so good. They were covered in like seasoning salt and lemon pepper seasoning. They were delicious. And then I had chicken and waffles on a stick, which is essentially just like a big chicken tender that's breaded in like waffle batter, and then it's I assume it's pressed in a waffle iron because it's like, it's got the waffle indents in it, like it looks like a waffle. And then they give you maple syrup and powdered sugar to put on it. It was really good. I have never had actual chicken and waffles, but I think I would be into it. Something about like the sweetness, and I really like waffles. The other thing I liked about this version of chicken and waffles that I don't think I would like about actual chicken and waffles is chicken and waffles, I think typically they give you like an actual piece of chicken, like a thigh or like a leg or something. And, oh, the cat's here. He's bumping my hand. Oh my God. Kitty. And that's fine, but this is how I know that I was like spoiled for dinners when I was growing up, because I liked that the chicken and waffles on a stick was just like a chicken tender. Like, there wasn't any like gristly parts in it or like bone, or I don't like eating chicken that's like actual chicken. Like, fried chicken doesn't appeal to me at all because there's like those fatty bits, and I understand that this is a totally lame thing for me to be saying, essentially, that I don't like actual chicken. I just like, you know, chicken that's, like, formed into a tender. I just like pure white meat chicken with, like, no actual, like, chickenness in it. So that's why I liked the chicken and waffles on a stick. And then what else did we eat? Then I got some ice cream, chocolate vanilla twist in a cup with sprinkles and nuts on it. And then I got a Coke. It was so good. It was so fun. My mom got some deep fried green beans, and then we had a couple lemonades, and then she had some of those fries, and then she had some of my ice cream. It was so fun. So that's what we did today. My parents are going to Minot for the weekend, and I actually ended up having a 3-day weekend this week, and so I totally could have gone with them, but which sounds fun, but I don't need to do any shopping, and I just couldn't really justify the expense. So I'm not going. My mom is always, like, super sweet and goes to Victoria's Secret for me. Because I don't know if you have ever tried to order online from Victoria's Secret, but the shipping is egregious. It's like $60 shipping. And I always look for, like, cute sale bras, right? Like, I'm, you know. And so then having to pay enough in shipping for, like, to get a bra and a half out of that shipping money and wasting it on shipping is ridiculous to me. So I always put stuff in my cart, and then I never end up ordering from them because the shipping is ridiculous. And they won't ship to a store. There's a Victoria's Secret in Saskatoon, which is pretty close to me, but they won't ship to there, so I can just go and pick it up. Stupid. So she'll just go check that out for me, and that's fine. I'm fine with not going to Minot. Although I do like shopping, and I do like going to American drugstores. There's a lot of stuff in, like, or just drugstores we don't have here. I was going to say CVS. I think that's an American drugstore, but they might have it in Canada and just in bigger cities. But because they just have so much drugstore makeup that we don't have up here. So I do like shopping for drugstore makeup in the States, but I don't need any of that. So my plan right now is, what time is it? It's 6 o'clock, and I'm probably not going to eat supper because I am so full from eating all that food at the fair. I might have some cereal later. And I'm taping the Olympics, the opening ceremonies, all 5 hours of it. And I think I'm just going to have a relaxing evening. I have no idea what I'm going to stitch on. I kind of want to stitch on Death by Cross Stitch, but I think I might put that away because that is the project that I'm going to take to Bumbershoot at the end of the month, and I don't want to get sick of it before then, and it's kind of the only thing I want to take to Bumbershoot because it's only one color. It's the easiest thing to pack. So I should just go through. I could work on the perennial border. I could put some colorful bits into there. I might do that. So yeah, that is my plan for tonight. Tomorrow, everything is happening this weekend. Normally, exhibition, the X, and our folk festival fall on different weeks, but this year, because of some scheduling reason, it's all this weekend. So I haven't bought a ticket for Folk Fest in years to actually go to, like, the concerts at night. And usually I have to work, so I can't stay for the headliner anyways. But I think I'm going to go down tomorrow. I live pretty close to the park, so I'm just going to walk down there with my blanket and my book. And just, they have a lot of free daytime stuff, like smaller stages where people will play small sets or whatever. Last year, I think it was last year, the year before I went down there, and Joel Plaskett, who I love, was one of the headliners, but he was also playing at one of the small stages. So I just sat on the grass for free and listened to Joel Plaskett play, like, a 7-song set, and he played the songs I wanted to hear. Like, I think he started with, like, Park Avenue Sobriety Test, and I was like, this is the song I want to hear. So it was awesome. I just went all day and had some lunch down there at one of the food trucks and just sat in the sun and read my book and listened to music and looked at all the cute kids, because Folk Fest always has the cutest kids and the cutest families. And then at 6 o'clock, when they started taking, like, tickets for the main gate, I just went home. And it was kind of the best. So I'm going to try and do that tomorrow. And then Suicide Squad opens this weekend. And I've been waiting for Suicide Squad for months. I'm very excited about it. I know the reviews are not great, but I still think it's going to be good because I just think it's going to be fun and like brightly colored and pretty to look at, and I'm just excited for it. So that's my plan. Tomorrow, Folk Fest. Sunday, Suicide Squad. And then I also have Monday off. So this is going to be a really great weekend, you guys. I think this is going to be a really great weekend. Also, I'm going to finish that virtual race. I have 2.3 miles left to do, which I'm hoping... I wanted to knock it out tonight because I know that Tracy is going to finish today, and I really wanted to finish on the same day as her, but that's okay. I'll finish the day after her. So, yeah. Like I said, I was going to do that today, but it's 6 o'clock now, and I feel like garbage, and I'm so full of food, and I just walked like a million miles at the X that I can't motivate myself to like go up to the gym and do some more miles. So that's my plan for tonight. Sit, maybe watch some opening ceremonies, stitch on something, and have a good sleep. So I will catch up with you guys tomorrow. Hey guys, it's August 6th today. I don't know what that wave was. Hey guys, I'm casting a spell on you. First day off today, had a pretty great day. I finished my race this morning, the virtual race that I was doing through YesFit with Tracy. I had 2.3 miles left, so I did that this morning. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do another one through there or not. It's a little expensive to me. It's $25 American to sign up, and then they send you the medal, which is like 30 whatever dollars Canadian, and I think I'm just gonna look for like a good, like an online fitness tracker. I think that would be it, as much motivation as this website was. Just hopefully I won't have to pay quite that much to get it. So I did that. Then I did some running around, and it's Folk Fest this weekend, so I walked down to the park to check out the like the free daytime stuff, just for like an hour and a half. I just walked down, had some lemonade, watched a pretty cool French jazz hip-hop fusion band, really cool. And then I walked back, and now I am, like, really overheated. So I am ready to stitch. It's, like, 6 o'clock. I started, last night I decided to work on the perennial border, and I started putting in the actual border with the flowers in it, and it is so pretty, you guys. I had no idea that it would be as pretty as it is. So I'm going to show you what I've done there. Netflix. So I watched all of BoJack Horseman season 3 last Saturday. I watched it all in one night. Man, that show was really good. That show was really, 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 really good. So I started watching Spy last night, the Melissa McCarthy movie. I only got like 20 minutes in, and then I decided that I wanted to listen to a podcast, but I think I might finish that because it seemed pretty funny. And I taped the Olympic opening ceremonies. I haven't watched any of that yet. So yeah, let me show you the perennial border. So this is the perennial border. The cat's right here. P.S. So I just started up here with the hydrangeas. And I think they're so pretty. The half of these leaves, the lighter half, that's a variegated Threadworks color. Everything else is just plain DMC though, I think. And I don't know what it is. I think they're really, really nice looking. And then last night I put in the greenery here for the iris. And I'm just going to keep working on this. Sorry, lots of sirens today. There's no specialty stitches in the hydrangea one, and I don't think there's any in the iris, so I'm loving that. There's not a specialty stitch in each, like, clump of flowers. So yeah, I'm going to work on this tonight. Oh, that's so pretty. Hey guys, it's August 7th today, and I just saw Suicide Squad. Let's talk about it for a hot second. I know this isn't a movie review channel, but let's talk about it. So, Suicide Squad was my number 2 most looked forward to movie of this year. Civil War was number 1. And we know there's a whole Marvel DC thing where like DC movies aren't great necessarily, and Marvel movies are great. I liked Suicide Squad. It's not perfect, but it's not like the dumpster fire that the internet is making it out to be. Like, all these reviews are like, it's terrible, it's worse than Batman v Superman, blah blah blah. Yeah, no, it's not a garbage heap. It's fine. Firstly, positives or negatives first? Negatives. The plot is kind of shaky at times. Like, I'm sure if I really thought about the, like, whole evil plan at the center of it, the, like, taking over the world, whatever, I think I would have some questions about that. Like, I'm sure there's some holes in there. And also, like, why would you introduce, like, Katana, who I understand that she's not part of the squad, she's Rick Flag's bodyguard, but, like, why would you not introduce her at the same time as you're introducing all the other characters, like Rick Flag? Like, it wouldn't be hard to just be like, this is my bodyguard, Katana, you know what I mean? And, like, she gets a backstory and, like, an appropriate flashback expository moment, but, like, she just, like, literally walks onto the helicarrier when they're all leaving to go to Midway City, and Rick Flag's like, this is Katana. And it's like, why didn't you establish that when everybody else was established? That's really, really puzzling to me. And the other thing, Slipknot. Okay, minor spoilers for Suicide Squad. Not a big deal. It's 100% not a big deal because everybody was pretty sure that Slipknot was going to die in this movie. Slipknot dies in this movie immediately. He's the guy in the trailer that gets out of the van and punches the lady, and he's got, like, braids. Yeah, you don't know who he is because he's not part of the team and he lives for, like, 10 minutes. He wasn't really in any of the promotional stuff. He's in the trailer for, like, 3 seconds. So it became pretty obvious that he was going to die immediately. And he does die immediately. But it's like, he wasn't established in any way. Like, he showed up when they were all getting ready to leave. And Rick Flag was like, that's Slipknot. He can climb anything or something. I don't even remember what he said. Isn't he a knot guy? He didn't say anything about knots. And then he dies immediately when they get to the city. And it's like, if you're trying to establish the stakes of this mission by killing somebody off, you have to make it somebody that, like, anybody gives a shit about. Like, don't make it this guy, who we know nothing about, and who I think had one line of dialogue before they got to the city. And then, like, he's dead. Oh, who cares? All right, that's all the negative stuff I'm going to talk about. And it's all plot stuff. It's all story stuff. So, God, I have an eyelash issue, I'm sorry. So I get, it's pretty obvious that this, they were talking about how this movie was recut a couple of times to be funnier after Batman v Superman was so dour. And then also, I think, recut to be more like the first trailer, because the first trailer is beautiful and, like, amazing and nihilistic and awesome, and this movie really isn't, but it seems like they tried to move around a lot of stuff last minute, and you can kind of tell plot-wise. Okay, the good stuff is that it looks amazing. It looks like a comic book movie, this kind of, like, neon craziness that you saw in all the trailers and stuff, that is in there, and it looks beautiful. The colors are amazing. Everybody looks great. Everybody's, like, bright. And, like, for instance, that was a big, you can tell that this is a big, like, pushback from Batman v Superman, because Batman v Superman was, like, gray, like, non-colorful, you know what I mean? And you can see now in this movie and also in the new Justice League promo photos, everyone's brighter. Like, Superman's brighter, Wonder Woman's brighter, like, everybody looks more like a comic book character. So that's good. What else? Enchantress. The Enchantress stuff looked amazing. There was maybe one scene where I was like, this CGI is not great, but other than that, she looks amazing. She looks so crazy good, and she's got all this weird dust stuff around her that looks great. And there's a lot of, like, horror-influenced stuff. At least that's what I kind of saw. Like, you know when you see, like, J-horror or K-horror, the, like, I forget the name of them. The spirits with the long black hair and the pale skin, and some of that I think must have been an influence. Because, like, for instance, there's a scene, this is not spoiling anything, there's a scene where she is, it's like a very classic horror moment where there's a guy at a sink washing his hands, there's a mirror in front of him, and we see her in the mirror, he's not looking up, so it seems like she's behind him, but he doesn't know. And then when he looks up, he sees her, and she grabs him through the mirror. Like, it's very J-horror. It reminded me, like, of The Grudge. So she looks great. There's a moment when you first see her transform that looks great, which I think was in one of the first, not the first, one of the newest trailer bits with the hand, where it's, like, June's hand, and then Enchantress's hand comes up and grabs it and then flips it around, and then she's Enchantress. That looks great. There is a member of the Justice League in this movie, super briefly. It's like a 20-second cameo. It's not Batman, although Batman is in this movie. And that was awesome. Like, I was not expecting it. It was really great. It makes me really excited for that upcoming movie. That was cool. Will Smith can still carry a movie. Absolutely, if you were doubtful of that. He's great. And I also really like him as this, like, anti-hero. I mean, he's still very much a hero, but you know, there's like a darkness to him in this movie that I think he carries really well, because he's always been such a Hollywood hero kind of guy. Harley Quinn looked great. Everything was great in that vein. The Joker. This is an unpopular opinion. I know. I'm full of unpopular opinions. I really like this Joker. I like Jared Leto a lot, so I'm kind of biased because it's Jared Leto. I think he looks good. I like this, like, kind of new 52 inspired, like, like slimy card sharky Joker with, he's got these like metallic blazers on all the time, and like, I understand that people don't like him. He's not in the movie very much. That's maybe a spoiler, but he's definitely not in the movie a lot. But his voice, the voice is perfection to me. I think he nailed the voice. And, like, I can only imagine how hard it would be to try and be the Joker after Heath Ledger was the Joker. So you kind of have to go, like, you really have to make a left turn in order to make it anything, because Heath Ledger was so amazing. So, is that it? I like the Joker. I like the squad. I like the look of it. I like the Justice League cameo. That was awesome. I think that's it. Oh, one more thing. I saw every bit of promotional material, I think, at least every North American bit of promotional material for this movie before it came out. I saw every trailer. I saw every little bit of footage from, like, Comic-Con and from everything, and I still did not know the entire plot of this movie. That's amazing. That's great. Keep that up. Because remember when Batman v Superman came out, the trailer, and everyone was like, well, I know exactly what's going to happen in this movie. Yeah, everyone did, because it was a poorly cut trailer, and it gave away, like, the entire plot of the movie. This does not. Like, there were surprises in this movie, which was awesome. Oh, and, okay, Common. You know, Common's in this movie. And I remember leading up to this movie coming out, everyone was like, who's Common playing? Is he this guy? Is he this guy in the subway? Where's Common in the trailer? You know, and Common's in this movie for like 4 minutes. Everyone was wrong about everything in regards to Common's character. He's not anything. It's just really funny that's in this, like, age of trailer breakdowns, which I love, by the way. I love trailer breakdowns. It's easy to be, like, to make a whole bunch of connections that just aren't there, and then you see the movie and you're like, oh, never mind. It's just a small, very, very small supporting role. So anyways, Suicide Squad. I'm glad it's out. I'm glad I saw it. It was enjoyable. I liked it a lot. So, I am going to stitch for a bit tonight. I have no idea on what. I finished up the next little section of the perennial border, the iris section, and then I went to move on to the next one, and there's so many lazy daisies in it. It's like 90% lazy daisies, and I just couldn't power through it, so I left that. And so now I have no idea what I'm going to stitch on. Maybe Angel of Love? Maybe?
But other than that, I don't know. So I am gonna figure something out and then I will talk to you later.
Hey guys, it's August 12th today. and this week has been really nuts. I was supposed to have a 3-day weekend last weekend, so Saturday, sorry, cat's here. Okay. I was supposed to have a 3-day weekend last weekend, so Saturday, Sunday, Monday off, and then my coworker phoned in sick on Monday, and my other coworker has been on vacation for the last week, so I had to come in on my day off on Monday. Well, I didn't have to come in on Monday, but so my boss phoned me at 5:07 in the morning. My alarm was set for 6 because I had to work the next day, so I couldn't really sleep in, you know. But I didn't get to bed until like 11. So I got this call at 5:07 and my first thought was like, oh my God, was I supposed to be at work today? Like, you know, you have that like panic moment. But no, so I did go in because, I don't know, because I give a shit. And I know that like so many people would not go in, but like I feel responsible, you know, you guys, I don't know. In my experience, the people I've met in this community are very like-minded to me, and it has been kind of a rude awakening these last, like, 6 to 8 years, realizing that not everybody has the same work ethic as you do, and not everybody cares as much as you do, and people that are older than you don't necessarily have to be more mature than you. Anyways, so I went into work on Monday, and it just totally threw off my week. Like, my sleeping has been kind of wacky, and I've just been so tired, and then the next couple of days were really busy, and now this weekend is going to be busy, and I was already scheduled for a 7-day stretch, which is now an 8-day stretch because of that Monday. So it's Friday right now, and I have next Tuesday, Wednesday off. And I just, I'm just over halfway done. That's a terrible feeling. So anyway, so that happened Monday. And then Tuesday, we had our big appointment at the doctor's office for my dad, which was good. It was good news. It was better news than I think anybody was expecting. So the spots haven't changed much. There hasn't been, like, any radical growth or anything. So that just basically means that my dad has lots of options and lots of time to decide what he wants to do. And I think he has decided, but that's the, like, arguably the one good thing about not doing a curative treatment. Like, my dad's cancer is not curative anymore. So any chemo that he does or any treatment that he does is just to slow it down. It won't go away at this point. So the benefit of that is that there's really, like, no huge rush to make any decisions. That sounds kind of morbid, but, you know, if it's curative, obviously you want to get, like, right on top of it as fast as you can, and you want to shrink it, and you want to get rid of it, but my dad's is a little bit of a different case. So that was good. That was a really good appointment, but I was really stressed about it, and I didn't realize how stressed I was about it until it was over, and I felt, like, exhausted. So that was Tuesday. Wednesday, Thursday, work was really busy. And today it's Friday. I haven't been stitching too much. I've been doing a little bit on Angel of Love. I might work on Death by Cross Stitch tonight. Man, that is just the easiest project. It's just makes my brain happy right now. I haven't watched any of the Olympics except for the opening ceremonies. Haven't watched any baseball. I just have been such a blah, like, lump this whole week. I bought a Fitbit because I think those Yes Fit races, I really love the idea of those, but I think they're just going to be too expensive for me. They're not expensive, but I can't justify spending that money. So instead, I made a significantly higher investment and bought a Fitbit. But I really like it. It's
clipped on my bra right now, which is a way you can wear it. I have the Fitbit one, and they say you can like wear it in your pocket, or you can clip it on your belt, or you can clip it to your bra, and that's amazing. Like, whoever decided that they could market it that way to women, I salute you, because, I mean, I wear a uniform to work, and so now if I change my clothes, I don't have to worry about like transferring it. So I'll excuse me while I reach down my shirt. So this is the one I got. It's the Fitbit one. There's my steps. Lots of steps. So it shows the steps and the stairs you've climbed. The flights of stairs, 10 for me. Miles walked, 6.2. And calories burned, I don't know, 2,200? I don't know. I don't know anything about calories, really. And then there's a little flower that grows depending on how active you are that day. And the time. It's 4:13. So yeah, I really like it, and I really like being able to wear it all the time. And like, I like being able to wear it when I work out. And I think the reason what really pushed me over the edge to get, like, look at how small it is. It's so small and like cute. What pushed me over the edge was I was trying to find an app for my phone that I could track my fitness on, like a fitness tracker. What I essentially wanted was an app where I could input my height and weight and age, whatever. And I didn't want it to be a pedometer because I can't carry my phone on me all day. I can't carry it while I'm working. And also my phone is big. Like, I feel like when I had a flip phone, that would be an option for me to carry my phone in my pocket all day. But like, if you've ever tried to jam a Samsung Galaxy into like the pants pocket of like women's pants, like women's jeans pocket, like it's not, it doesn't fit. So I can't carry my phone all day. And also I don't, it feels kind of like a battery suck to like have it track me all day. I don't know if that's true. That's unsubstantiated. That's just my first impression of it, is that it seems like it would drain my battery. So I didn't want a pedometer in the app. I just wanted an app that I could like track my steps on, like that I could like type my steps into. And I also wanted something that I could input my workouts into. So if I went upstairs and used the elliptical, I could put in how far I went and how much time it took and how many calories I burned according to the machine or whatever. That's all I wanted. I just wanted an app that would like track those things for me. And it was surprisingly hard to find. I downloaded like 8 or 10 of them and uninstalled them, and they were either too complicated, like they would track, like they were run trackers, so they would track your run outside with the GPS. Well, I don't run outside. Or they would give you routes that your friends had run, or like people in your city. I don't need that. Or you could track your workout on them, meaning you could like log what you were bench pressing in them and like how many reps you were doing of things. I don't need that. So it just, I found a lot of apps that like didn't, I was only using like 10% of, and even then it didn't work really well for me. Or they just like, they weren't very aesthetically pleasing to me. That's silly. But I mean, it's an app and I'm going to look at it all day. So, but the one that I liked the most was the Fitbit app. I downloaded it and I just didn't have a device to link to it, but it lets you for free, like, input your workouts and track your food if you want and your water and stuff. It's not ideal. Obviously, the incentive is to buy the device. Works better, looks cleaner. And yeah, so that was the app I liked the most. I'll bring it up actually on my phone. I just think it looks really great, and like, that is enough incentive for me. I think. So we'll see how this goes. And if, you know, I end up not liking it, I know like my mom would take this Fitbit. She really likes this model. So I'm just thinking here. My Fitbit does take a while to sync on here. Oh, and I also, so I wore it to bed also. It's supposed to be able to track your sleep. I don't know how well that went. So I have a sleep tracker app on my phone. And I use it because, again, I like the interface of it. I think it looks nice. And also,
I like the data it gives you. I don't know how entirely reliable that data is. I know it has something to do with, it gauges how much movement there is. Like, you put it on your mattress, and then it gauges essentially how much you're rolling over and how much you're moving, and that has something to do with how well you're sleeping. I don't know how it can tell, like, when you're in deep sleep, although I know that when you're in deep sleep, you're supposed to be, like, the most still. Anyways, so I have an app on my phone that I use for that, and that's also my app that I use as my alarm clock. I really like it because it lets you set a whole bunch of things for your alarm. So my wake up sound is a thunderstorm. I know that's weird. That's really weird to some people and also really awesome to some people. So I am a thunderstorm person. So it wakes me up to thunderstorm noises. And then I do two little math equations before I can shut it off. So it's perfect. It wakes me up and, like, it kicks my brain into gear, because my problem with a clock radio is that I can just hit the snooze button, and I will, because it's 3:30 in the morning and I will hit the snooze button. So since I've started using that sleep tracker app, which has been probably at least 9 months, I haven't been late to work. I haven't woken up late, which is amazing, really. So I already have something I'm tracking my sleep through, but I figured if I was wearing my Fitbit anyways, then I would try that. And so here's the Fitbit app. Oh, right. You can't see any of this. Just a second. Okay, I still don't know how well this is going to show on the screen, but this is the Fitbit app. There's my little Fitbit One. And so then it shows your steps and your miles and your calories, how many floors you've climbed, how many active minutes you've done, and then you can, like, input a workout if you want. Oh, that's my weight. Hi, everybody. That's how much I weigh. And so this is my sleep result from the other night. I don't know how I feel about showing everybody how much I weigh. Whatever. It's fine. It's truly fine. So I wore it to bed, and essentially what you do when you're ready to go to sleep is you just hold down the little button on here for like 2 seconds, and it starts counting, like it looks like a stopwatch, and then you just, like, put it in your armband. It comes with an armband. Put it in your armband and go to sleep, and then when you wake up, you press the button for 2 seconds again, and it stops the timer. So when I woke up this morning and I hit the button, it had been timing for like 7 hours and something. But the thing I find interesting is if I open up the program, it says that I was awake one time. I don't know how I would know that. And that I was restless 11 times, meaning I probably rolled around 11 times. And this is the kicker to me. 7 minutes for me to fall asleep. That is straight up BS. It takes me at least 25 minutes, like half an hour, to fall asleep. I'm sure what that means is, like, I was really still after 7 minutes, because it's all movement based, right? There's not a heart monitor in here. This is just movement based. So if you know anything about sleep tracking apps, I would love to know, like, how would it know the difference between the one time I was awake and the 11 times I was restless? I don't know. Anyways, so that's my Fitbit. I bought that. Yeah, I really like it. And I know myself pretty well. I'm not really like a fad type of person, so I don't think this is like an impulse purchase. I'm really happy to use it, actually. And that's kind of everything that's been going on. It has been, like I said, a really exhausting week, and I haven't really been stitching that much. And I'm getting kind of nervous about my Seattle trip. I'm excited, but I'm excited in the back of my head, and I'm nervous in, like, the forefront of my mind, because I haven't flown internationally by myself before, and I haven't been to either of the airports that I'm doing my layovers in. So I'm a worrier, so I'm just worrying about it. And I can't really plan for it, and I really like to be able to plan for every possible thing, and I can't plan for this situation of, like, me not doing it before, so not having done it before. So, yeah, I'm just kind of starting to think about that, because it's getting to the middle of the month, and that's happening at the end of this month. And, yeah, that is taking up all the space in my brain right now. Hey, guys. So it's August 14th today. And I just had a really tough work week, like probably the toughest week I've ever had in this job in terms of, like, tiredness and work level and just like general disappointment. So my parents and I went out for supper tonight. We went to Eastside Mario's because they have their promotion on right now where you like buy a certain meal and then you get another meal to take home. So we did that and I got slightly tipsy at supper. Full disclosure, it has been a super tough week and I haven't really been like even a little buzzed in probably 2 years, like a year and a half. It's just not something I do that often, but I'm a little buzzed now. And I am going to, I'm going to keep it rolling. I'm going to drink my Pombay and I'm going to stitch and try not to make too many mistakes on Angel of Love, probably. Hey guys, it's August 18th today. I am kind of a hot mess today. I have this cough situation that I don't quite understand. And I had the worst sleep last night. Like normally I sleep pretty well. But I did not sleep well last night. I was so restless all night, and now I am so tired that it's like 3 in the afternoon right now, and I should go to bed early tonight. I should go to bed at like 7. So I was so tired, I almost had a nap, and then I had to call my mom and be like, please talk to me on the phone so that I don't fall asleep and have a nap instead. So I'm going to do a little bit of stitching, I think. I'm working on Death by Cross Stitch. Big surprise, no surprise. Because my brain doesn't work today, and that's my brain shut-off project. But the reason I wanted to film a little bit is because my mom came over a couple days ago and helped me hang pictures. So I finally have stuff on my walls. So let me show you what's on my walls. So this guy you've already seen. This is Hold On to That Branch or Die Cat. It's a reproduction of a poster that was seen in the show Gravity Falls. I got this on Redbubble. This is a 16 by 20, roughly. I had to cut it down a little bit to fit it in this frame. This is a 16 by 20 frame. it's just a poster. It's from Redbubble. As I said, you can pick whatever size you want. I picked the big one to go on top of my super messy DVD collection. I haven't hung the Rick and Morty one yet. I'm hoping to hang that one with one of those. It's such a weird size. It's really long and skinny. And so I think I want to hang it with one of those things where you like attach it at the top and then you attach something at the bottom and it just kind of hangs like a scroll. I think that might be the best solution for that one. So that one's not up yet, but this one is. And then over in this corner that Dexter never uses, he hasn't been on that or in that since we moved here. So I don't know how he feels about that. This lovely lady is called I Can't Explain, and it's by John Clark, I believe. I got this years ago. Tracy, I think you have this one. I think Tracy has this exact same one, which is why we're kindred spirits. This is called I Can't Explain. It says I Can't Explain right there. And John Clark has a series of these projects where he paints a woman's face on top of the page of a book, and I just thought this one was really beautiful. I really love this lady, I really love her face, and I love that it says I Can't Explain. I did Google this page to find out what book it was from. I can't remember now. I want to say it was like a Sherlock Holmes book, but I just Googled kind of bits and pieces of the text that I could see, and I did end up finding it, so that's very cool. That is by John Clark. This beauty you may remember from my bedroom in my parents' house. I love this piece. This is Frank Sinatra's mugshot, blown up, obviously, and then screened onto canvas. So let's just take a moment to appreciate. Look at this babe. Frank Sinatra was a babe in his youth. I'm sorry, that's just true. This is a black and white photo, and he has blue eyes. Look at how blue his eyes would have been. Man, yep, he was pretty handsome. So I have this mugshot because I really like Frank Sinatra, and I also really like this mugshot. If you get all the way down to the bottom of it, it says name Frank Sinatra, address, his address in Hoboken. He was arrested in 1938, and his crime was seduction, which I think just means that he was caught with a married woman. So he was 5'8", short guy, shorter than me, And it says occupation singer, which is maybe my favorite part of this whole thing. So that is Frank Sinatra's mugshot. I have had that piece for a very long time, and I really love it. Okay, into my bedroom now. I'll start with this little piece. So, sorry it's dark in here. I think I mentioned I don't have an overhead light in my bedroom, so this is probably the wrong time of day to be doing this. This is a, how to film this best. This is a little, oh, hello me. This is a little black and white photo that was given to me by my good friend Claire. It is called, Yes, Columbus Did Discover America. And the reason she got it for me, I think, is because my birthday is November 8th, and it says right here on this vehicle November 7th, which is pretty close. But I think she knew that I would really like this. So there's writing all over the car and the awning there, and it says, lies are falling thick and fast, and the truth marches on. I don't know much about this photo. If you happen to know anything about this photo, I would love to know more about it. But that has always hung kind of over my desk. And then I have these two little canvas pieces. I have had these for years and never had them up. I bought them maybe 8 to 10 years ago, and this is the first time they've ever been on a wall. Even in my mom's house, they were just in a bag in my closet because I never had any room to put them. So, start with this one. This is, look at this lovely, like, babe of a woman with their humongous hoop earrings. And then it has an Emily Dickinson quote at the top. It says, dwell in possibility. You can see there's like an overlay of glitter on some of the leaves here. And then the other one, this is my favorite one. It's much more pink than I remember. I didn't remember that it was like all pink, but I still love it. So it is this little bird with glittery wings. And then it says, you are a rare bird, which is something that my mom always used to say. And, well, still says, and just a saying that I really, really love. You are a rare bird. So these pieces are both from a company called Papaya, and the website is on the back of them. I saw it when I hung them, and so I actually just went to the website the other day to make sure it still existed, and it does. So the website is papayaart.com, papayaart.com, and I couldn't find either of these specific ones on that website. I'm not even sure they make canvas prints like this anymore. I think they more do poster prints now. But if you like either of these, that website has hundreds of things just like this. Inspirational quotes, really beautiful, like beautifully designed pieces. They do cards, they do stationery, they do notebooks, they do pretty much every possible thing you could want. So yeah, that's Papaya. And those are the things on my wall.
Hey guys, it's August 21st, and it is just under 2 weeks until I go to Seattle. I am super excited. I'm getting really excited now. I have today off, and I have tomorrow off, and then I work 7 days, I think, at work, and then my days off start for Seattle. So, Toddlers and Tiaras is back. You guys, that little national treasure of reality television. And so they've been playing so many episodes on TLC up until it's on. I think it's on Wednesday. And I have taped so many episodes of Toddlers and Tiaras. There are so many episodes on my PVR right now. So I'm going to stitch on Death by Cross Stitch. And it's going to get real weird. It's going to be a real weird night full of pageants. Hey guys, it's August 26th today, and I don't remember when the last time was that I filmed, but I think this vlog has gone off the tracks a little bit. This whole last week has been, like, there's been the cat's bumping my hand. There's been a lot of work stuff, and trying to really buckle down on my course, and I've been, excuse me. Jeez, I've been, I think just generally a lot of my, like, mental energy has been spent on this trip that I have coming up, trying to get everything in line for that, and I haven't been stitching that much. I've only been stitching on Death by Cross Stitch, which I said I was going to save for Seattle, but I might just stitch it all the way through until Seattle and also take it to Seattle. So, what has been going on? On Saturday,
last Saturday. I watched the Tragically Hip concert, which just destroyed me. I was already having like a really hyper emotional day. And then I watched that and it just made me cry like 700 times and then like really cry at the end. So if you're unfamiliar with Canada or Canadian music or the Tragically Hip is a Canadian band, pretty prolific up here, I think. I don't own any of their albums and I don't really know a whole ton of their songs, but like if you are a Canadian between the ages of, let's say, 20 and like 35 plus, you have an affinity for the Tragically Hip because they've just always been like our band. And so last December, I believe, really late last year, it came out that the lead singer slash songwriter of the Tragically Hip, Gord Downey, has terminal brain cancer. So this year has been like they've been touring throughout Canada and it's been like their last tour. And on Saturday, they played what is likely to be their last show ever in their hometown, which is Kingston, Ontario, which is also where I was born, which is pretty cool. We only lived there for like a couple years. I have zero memory of Kingston, but that's kind of cool. So they aired this big, they just like live streamed the concert in Kingston, the like last hip concert ever. All across Canada. They put it on CBC and they cut into the Olympic coverage to show it, at least on CBC. And it was super great. It just, yeah. I probably should have filmed about this like closer to when I watched it because I had a lot more to say, but Gord was so amazing and like strong, but also you could tell how much he was struggling because he's a very, very sick man and he had like teleprompters. They had teleprompters up everywhere because I think he's starting to forget stuff and he just seemed like he should be exhausted after it. And they played for almost 3 hours. They did three encores. And I've watched it twice. I watched it on Saturday. I taped it and watched it like an hour after it started. My parents and I went out for supper on Saturday night. And so when I got home, I started watching it. And then I watched it again earlier this week. And then I watched bits of it a third time. The very end, they ended with Ahead by a Century, which is one of those songs, if you don't know the Tragically Hip very well, you probably have heard that song. That one and like My Music at Work. And there are a couple that had crossed over like into the States, not huge, but just enough that you'd probably go like, oh, I've heard that song. So they ended with Ahead by a Century, which I have listened to a third time since then, watched a third time. And I've also watched the opening again, because they opened with 50 Mission Cap and then they played Wheat Kings like third, I think. And I really love Wheat Kings. I like that song a lot. So it was very cool and it was very Canadian. And they say that like 1 in 3 Canadians watched it. It's like over 11 million people watched it that night. And it was very cool, I think, of the CBC to put it on the way that they did. I was very proud of my broadcast, Canadian broadcasting station, because they could have made so much money airing that show. They could have put a big like Coca-Cola banner behind Gord's head and they could have charged like Super Bowl money to run ads during that show, but they didn't. They put it on in the middle of the Olympics, ad-free, no ads, no commercials, uncensored for 3 hours, and they just let the Tragically Hip play. And there, okay, so pardon my language, but they have a song called Tired as Fuck, and he got to sing all the fucks. It was totally uncensored. It was so cool. I think it was really, I don't know. I'm gushing about this. I don't know why. I thought it was very cool of CBC to do that in the way that they did and just let it feel like you were at this concert because, you know, at least one third of Canadians would have liked to be at that concert and just to show it the way they did. And they were so good. The band was so good. Anyways, am I done talking about this? No, I'm not. So right after the first few songs, this tour, Gordani has been wearing these like insanely metallic suits, sparkly suits, and this like fancy hat. And he opened his like suit jacket and he had a Jaws shirt on underneath. And like, so this is a man that has terminal brain cancer and he's on stage singing his heart out wearing a Jaws shirt, like as if some kind of monster under the surface could break through at any moment and kill him. Like the most amazing self-referential shirt for a terminal cancer patient to wear. And then at one point in the concert he said, "Do you hear a shark?" Like, he was so classy, and like I said, it really wrecked me at the end, because in the second encore, he just starts, like, at the very end of a song, he just, like, starts screaming and crying, and he's, like, hugged himself, and he just seemed, like, very small all of a sudden. He's 52, did I say that? He's in his 50s, he's so young, and he really seemed sick in that moment, and it was really heartbreaking. And then they came out for a third encore, and I don't know how he rallied the energy for it, and I don't know how he kept his mood up for it, but it was amazing. So that was Saturday, and then on Monday I went to see War Dogs with my mom, which is pretty good. And that's kind of all that's happened. It's Friday now, and it's been a super busy week. It's the middle of the afternoon. I'm actually going out for lunch with my friend Cindy tonight, who I haven't seen in a while. Out for supper. So before then, I was gonna work on my class, but I'm gonna have a break from that. And there's a million things I have to do before I leave. I want to give everything a really good, like, clean, vacuum, dusting, wiping. I have to do laundry. There's so many things I have to do. But I'm just gonna sit and stitch, I think, and watch RuPaul's Drag Race is back. It's the All-Stars season. And it aired last night, and I taped it. So I'm gonna watch that, and I'm gonna stitch, and maybe I'm gonna watch some Toddlers and Tiaras again, because like I said last time, I have so many episodes on my PVR of that. And that's it. I'm gonna enjoy my afternoon. Hey guys, it's September 1st today, and I'm just gonna record a tiny little like bumper for the end of this vlog. I'm leaving for Seattle tomorrow, and I'm not gonna take my camcorder with me. Can't film in the festival anyways. So if you're friends with me on Facebook, I might post some photos on there. But otherwise, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.